your used to gray England skies, cloudy days, colder nights, and your heart's not right.
Hi, I'm Martin Osborne, and this is In Your House or In My House. Today we are going to be with Alaska, and she is already coming.
But if you sang along with me, do you think you could ever smile again? If you sang this melody, do you think you could laugh again, my friend? Just try for me. Sing.
Alaska, you're a singer, a composer, an actress, a television presenter, and one of the most important figures of the movida madrileña. Do you have anything left to do? Being one of the most influential figures of this country, can you tell us what influenced your lyrics of your songs at that time?
In the 80s, transition took place, so the restriction of a dictatorship was eliminated and the freedom of a democracy started. So this was noticed in my lyrics, and the freedom feelings was transmitted in the songs. For example, the groups Metallica and Ramones, do you know it?
Yes, yes.
Appear in this period.
Everyone is going out.
And Alaska, how do you remember this time in Spain?
This period can be defined as a revolution in which the main objective was scandalized, doing things that you have never done before. And they were politically and socially incorrect. All in all, when we were happy and everything in Spain was revolution.
The Spanish dictatorship caused a great delay in Spain, and thanks to movements such as La Movida, Spain turned out to be more modern than other countries. In which aspect do you consider that?
There were a lot of changes, especially in music, in which were limited as a unique style due to freedom justice. In 1979, the song Casi una chica como tú en un sitio como este caused a revolution in the society, and because there were more young people than ever, so who go to concerts, consume.
And I'll keep on waiting. I'll keep on waiting. I'll keep on.
But did La Movida influence politics?
La Movida was focused on the revolution to begin to create than in politics. Fashion was created with the appearance of Adolfo Domínguez, and also art, architecture, cinema.
And being that it is a period of many changes, how did Madrid live it?
I arrived in Madrid in the middle of Franco's dictatorship, but I don't remember exactly because I was a girl. But I remember, for example, the school. I had a very close regime. But in the 80s, the society changed and everything was different. For example, people wore unusual makeup with eyes and very sharp lips. And I remember a night when I went out of a party. I wanted to help a woman because she fell down, and she ran out of me because she thought that I was going to stealing or something like that. So we can see how the society was. And this was reflected on the cinemas.
And Alaska, do you think that some things were normalized at that moment?
People began to write about heroin and drugs in general. Things haven't been written before. The appearance of heroin had social consequences, appearing in movies like Eloy of Iglesia.
Alaska, I love you. Every time you come to the program, you conquer us. you are an example to follow because you always have your own opinion about things, and you never judge no one because of race, sex, or ideology. And the clear example is that it came from a Republican and Spanish exiled father and a right-wing mother. You continue to affirm that no one is right. So thank you so much for being here today.
You're used to grey England skies, cloudy days, cold and